So you can, if you, when you do experiment with it, you decide what, how much energy you want to extract back within a meter. You can go into hundreds of kilowatts if you load it the right way and if the transmission lines can take it. One of the biggest problems with a new system when you start loading, first of all, is your cable into the main, what main can take, and the secondly is how much you can push down the grid to the point of the divisions, substations, what you allow. You overrun substations and then the substations will create you a lot of problems when you overrun them. It's a surge up the channel. So these things we'll announce in the coming days to the governments to prepare the power stations for a normal shutdown in the coming months. Because you will get the transmission lines blowing up. You are pushing a field with a high power coming from power station and a field resisting it. What happens? This is what you get when the power stations, the substations get hit by the lightning. So this is not that you have the systems, you're going to go on. This needs a lot of planning by governments that we don't destroy what is part of the national asset. This is important. This is what I even explained today earlier on with Rick and Mr. Hoy to understand what we've entered. This is not just for you to have a free system, free energy anymore. This is looking after the national assets. This is looking after the people. This is why we work on the new ethos, not just me, the greed, I have energy, I'm finished. You put 1,000 people in one city, a small town, putting thing in, you know what's going to happen in the substation. This is your national asset. You cannot destroy it. This you have to understand. When people buy, today or tomorrow we announce a structure of informing governments when you purchase them, when you build them. It's your job to do it because otherwise you cause fires, you cause death. There are engineers down the line on cables, repairing, you don't know. Lines has to be protected. Self-greed should not lead to destruction. So please, now that we open this channel, if your target was to produce energy, understand the consequences of it. That's why we say we don't need leadership, because we understand the problems, we do it ourselves in a correct way. Understand every kilometer of a high tension cable costs you, your work in past years for your government between $1 to $3 million per kilometer. If you want to destroy what is there, you're quite welcome. People in the cable, high power tension cables, can tell you how, if you haven't seen it, people hang on in helicopters, playing with their life to make sure winter, summer cable tension is correct, repairing connections. These are not the points you can go with a, what do you call it, a ladder. You don't want to kill the man and the helicopter down. So please understand we enter a position that we have to consider and follow a strict program. Not just we have it, we plug it in, I'm happy, forget about the jack. This is what we teach, not only the system, but the ethos and the method of using the system. Otherwise, we are back in the same problem path which has been in the past. I'm happy, I have it, forget about the rest. So don't forget, this could be your brother, your son, on the cable. If the pressure is too high, the fire down the line, it could be your grandma's or your brother's or your own son and child's house. So please understand, this is not a free forensic. This has to be organized now that it's free in the hand of people. Then you understand why we don't release the space. Let's see how humanity behaves with the free energy. It's not anymore, I produce electricity, forget about it, I have a warm house. But the problem with you is, you are the man with a gun in the hand. You are the man with a submachine shooting anything you like. If you want to murder, it's very easy. The more you take from the power of the system, unfortunately, the more you put into the system. And this is the danger. And the way we showed it yesterday is already watched, getting done by thousands of people, and in coming days by millions of people. We make announcement today. Hopefully, if our people in the background are ready to make the move, that yesterday was to show technology, today to understand the consequence of it. Free time is free time. But there are rules and regulations you have to follow. There are procedures you have to follow. I tell you something very simple. I've said from the beginning. You had your free energy. But don't forget, your life is not just made of energy. Hospitals, schools, roads, pensions, and a lot of other things the present society is a structure to look after. You have the free energy, no taxes, come to your son, there is no money in the government, no school for your child. You go sick, you haven't paid taxes because now you have a free energy, no hospital. So you have to understand the new system has to be structured. It has to be structured that what the mankind has worked so hard to create does not get destroyed. We keep the best part and we adopt it, but if with a free system you have on your table, it's a free run, don't forget, if the system does not work, you damage your soul, you're responsible for it. You have to pay with your own soul. This is where the correct conduct comes in. We announced today the Keshe Foundation will put, most probably before the end of the day, if we can do it, the units with the star formation, the base, everything done together as 1,000 euro. You can purchase it most probably in the coming hours from the foundation, delivery within 60 days, and as we build it up, we bring it to immediate within the next 90 days, 120 days as we see the demand. But 1,000 euro, we pay voluntarily by the choice of the purchaser to the nation which he belongs to. You are from Italy, 200 euro will be paid to your national government for replacing the jobs you have destroyed in the oil or the coal industry which supported the energy. You give an undertaking of additional 100 euro per year to the national reserve to keep everything in order. Which means you can have as much as you like, but you keep the structure going. The structure, what is good, has taken hundreds of years to develop, cannot be destroyed. Most of after expenses, the money will go back to support other part of the society, depending how we see it fit, initially supporting African and third world nations first to come up to the standard of the West. So when you pay 1,000 euro, and what I've done, those who bought, ordered the fire, the what you call 3 to 4 kilowatt power supply, I think there's about 25 left. The rest asked for the refund, they've been refunded. And these are the people close to the foundation, still staying loyal. All of these will be supplied with a new unit at a free cost. So we fulfill our commitment. So on the other hand, you were supposed to get to 3 to 4 kilowatts. Now you get everything free in the condition. But we still, for what we do, we will pay 200 to the country where you bought it from. So in fact, you fulfill your end of bargain, we do our end of bargain. So in reality, it is not a free energy, it's restructuring the society to, for its next step. If you do not pay the 100 euro, where are you going to find clean road? The police officers, the fire brigade, the ambulances and the nurses and the rest. This is how we set a new ethos and new system together. We restructure everything. If you're in Africa, you pay according to the African level. This morning I said to Mr. Hoy, the European level is at 1,000 euro. In China, 1,000 euro is too much. You balance it to what is for China, that the Chinese can all have the power supply. We estimate between 1 to 2 million supply units per month to start with. It takes us 2 or 3 months to reach it, and the China can reach it. Mr. Hoy is a capable man with his contacts in China and in power supply to meet the demand. So there is a lot of work is going on in the background to prepare governments, to prepare people to understand what is to come. If we don't do, it'll be governments after you. You're stealing the electricity in the background, you have to pay. This way, we confront first. We are using it, we are replacing for you to find a job for the ones we're taking the job away from. The stability of the society. We are prepared to put that much into the society. The same thing goes with your cars. When you buy a car unit, today we offer 2 different units. One is a car unit, one is an energy unit. Each one has the same condition. You got to realize something very important. This is going to come to you when you arrive within a short time. The road structure will become irrelevant in the coming years. Because cars in hovering, even a small distance from the ground, will not use the road. So the road maintenance, which is a major part of the infrastructure, will disappear. Grass will grow, the frame will be there, but it will become like Africa. Unless you want to pay for it to be there for your structure. As you heard yesterday, Alex tells you, his wheel feels very easy. It's an old car, he could feel it. Has no hydraulic steering. So the changes are on the way. We see it coming, we know it's there, and you have to be prepared for totality, not just the free energy. The free energy is the noose on the neck of human race if you do not do it the right way. Brother will kill brother, father will kill children, because had to be free, you didn't pay what it was supposed to be done, I'm sick, I'm dying, you stole from me. Because from now on, we stay correct the way it is. I've been asked, can we pay our 20% taxes to the foundation? You negotiate with the government. If it comes to, we will do. As I said, I build the system. I explained this earlier on. 70% taxes is too much because 50% of industry is black. 20% taxes is correct because 100% will be white. Of half, you still don't get nothing because you can't reinvest back. 20% is total investment in humanity, in the schools. So we have to restructure with what is available. Don't forget, you buy a car, there are no more taxes on the fuel. We had what Alex said yesterday. He's tanked a quarter of a tank in March, where he usually tanks every 3 weeks, and he still got a quarter. Oil industry has literally walked into an end. They abused it so much, now they have to stand it themselves. But the problem with it is, the oil industry is your family and friend and nation which was supporting it. So there is an evolution beyond man's imagination since yesterday. We opened the door. This is part of the push for universal peace. If we can agree and come to a conclusion very rapidly, the governments will find out in the next few days how people, we are waiting for people to announce they made, they copied, is in there. We've seen a surge in the purchase on the Keshe Foundation shop in the past 48 hours, in 24 hours, because we're monitoring what is going on, and we are nothing compared to what people are doing privately at home. We've seen a huge surge since we put the reactors up for sale 25, 48 hours ago. So people are there to test it. People are there taking the next step to move, and in the coming weeks we expect a huge demand. We are preparing to meet it. How far we can meet it means collectively. In the coming days, in the coming hours, we will release the blue pattern, the print of all the systems worldwide, the way we did with everything else we've done. Which means you don't need for Italy to build it, you build it in your nation. And it's a blueprint. It means it's there exactly how it should be. We've done it with the patents, the blueprints, the Keshe Foundation supporters will make it. We'll be headed by Alex, because he knows what to do. We have other people in the background already put the information in detail on the internet. We make a video exactly how to be done. People can do it. You want to order it, Keshe Foundation is there. World Keshe Foundations, other commercial people see, they jump on it. Then we expect the same thing back. Put the money back in the Keshe Foundation, your nation, to research, to develop more. We don't make Bill Gates anymore. Bill Gates are human beings. When they become rich, they become criminals, because they think as they're right. This time, no criminals. We do it collectively, and the Keshe Foundations around the world have to follow the same thing. There is one thing. My command is my wish. Anybody goes out of line, look what happens to your children, your house, your wife, and the rest. Because you're stolen, you have to pay back. It's not by fear. You take from the soul, you pay with the soul. So you are in the position of the control. Understand the change of the structure. The biggest problem for humanity from the day he gathered intelligence was how to keep warm and how to keep food. We tamed the rice, wheat, to what we wanted. We tamed the animals because they're all pack of plasmas. Now we have found the secret of plasma in a very simple system. What's next? So the changes are beyond your imagination today, but in the coming weeks and days, you will see if a number of people push and they don't do it the correct way, you will see riots. Because people will have the energy. What about the food? People have the food. What about the hospitals on sick? People will have the hospitals. What about the police force when they take my things? So I have not freed you. I put you in the course of total anarchy. Unless you decide to control yourselves. This is not a freedom unit. This is the noose around your neck. You decide how tight you want to make it. Free energy. You want to make water. Very easy. Create condensation. In a coming time, what we did in China regarding CO2, Alex has done a different way, other people are doing a different way. Your water, your food, your medicine will be totally free. In your hand, in your house. But not all of you are 18 years old, not all of you are educated, not all of you can educate the next children, otherwise they become like centuries ago, illiterate. The schools has to be there, the new ethos has to be there, and in fact, I have put you in the shackle of your own conscience than in the courts and governments. You want gold? Free energy. Make as much gold as you like. Don't forget, the more you take, the more you give. The more you give, the more you take. So the system is not energy anymore. The system is not to give you a free run. Actually, I have given you a gun in your hands. Now you decide when you're going to shoot the trigger. The trigger won't be tomorrow, because if you're in your 30s, you're healthy. The trigger comes when you are 60, 70, and there is no hospital because you never participated in it. The time has to come now that people walk into the places and put the money on the table. This is what I can contribute. Not governments like Italy, police force for taxes. In Italy, people are scared of breeding because the tax man might say you bred too much. Correct? So you police yourself, you get policed very easy. When it comes down the line, when you have 30s, you have children and there are no schools. And these things is not history. It will happen so rapidly that you will not understand. If we sell 1 million units of energy units in the next year, which I think is very, very conservative, it will run into millions. Italians will run for it. What's going to happen? No tax income from fuel, no tax income from energy. The biggest tax earners for your country. I tell you something, it's a part of experience in my lifetime. When I was about 14, we received the message, leave Tehran, the time will come that the roads and the streets of Tehran will be running with blood. Leave before the time comes. And we said, what a joke. 3 years later, the streets of Tehran was full of blood. The revolution came out of disgrace of the nation, betrayed by the others. I warn you the same. If you do not go the right way, you start eating each other. You go to a farm, it's free, I can fly in, take what I like, you go with somebody else's asset. People will start murdering each other out of what they can't have, the free energy cannot feed you. So I tell you a piece of advice. 1975, we had a warning. 1979, we received it. People were prepared to give sacks of money. They stole whatever they did to just get out of Iran. There was no road. There was no passage. And this is going to happen to you. This is a war. You do it to each other. Nobody will do it. No government will do it to each other. So understand, warning was 4 years. Your warning is 4 months. If you don't get it right within 4 or 5 months and people start putting energy out and don't pay taxes, government every night counts how much is collected that they can spend. Nothing to collect, no wages paid. In communist countries, even today, some doctors in hospitals haven't been paid for months because government doesn't have money. But the doctor goes to the hospital because one day they pay me. Dr. Elia Kostova said to us once, people come and they give me an orange because they have no money. I get people coming to me for my systems and they gave me a basket of nuts. That's all I can afford. Would you help me? Of course. So you got to structure it that people don't give you orange, but they give from the soul and what they have. It's not time of communist time to share. In Italy today, the situation is so bad. In Italy today, I take you 50 meters from where I live, in a 4-star hotel, staff have not been paid their January wages, sorry, their Christmas wages yet, and we are in June, in the most advanced nation, top 7 nations in the world, on paper. Today in Italy, I don't go any further, I take you to see the staff of the 4-star hotel. The hotel doesn't have money. We call it in English, where is the Englishman? Fair coats and no knickers. There is nothing underneath. The structure is falling apart and is kept. In government offices, it's not very far. This is all makeup ready to fall. The last sticks, and now we have introduced the last stick. The cookie is crumbling very fast. Huge prices of $1.40, $1.40 per liter. It's going to cost you, if you're correct, make your system, pay your taxes to the government, nothing. Very, very little if you do. I heard, I think Rick told me this morning, I was telling you lot, that Tesla has offered a car. You can go and charge it and come home and charge your house with the Tesla battery. You have to buy a Tesla car to charge a Tesla battery. I don't know, $10,000-$15,000 total. Now with less than $1,000, you do it at home, less than $50. You have everything for life. So I haven't given you a gift. And Alex wasn't brought here to give you freedom. We have given you, we are the messengers of death. That's exactly what we've done. We are messengers of death. We are Judas, you are whatever you call it. Because now we kill the past is the beginning of a new. It's you decide how you kill yourself. We brought you the message of freedom, the energy, everything else. It's you who decide. listen to what I suggest, the way we advise, you'll walk a path of peace in a correct way, you walk the way you want to go. I would like to see how many of you will be part of this gutter blood. Because when you don't pay these kind of heavy taxes, governments don't have the money to spend on arms. They reschedule the arm business. They reschedule the wars they plan because there is nothing to do. Or they create war to kill as many that they don't have that much people to pay taxes for. But in a way, they're on themselves. The option from yesterday has changed. You were happy, you receive a free energy system. But this is the chalice of poison. If you're a human, there's a chalice of poison, will not harm you. If you're a cobra, which you got it from, you decide which way you're gonna go. I have not given you a gift. I have given you a noose. It's you decide how you're gonna hang yourself. Free energy, free fuel. Most probably you can convert some of the energy to food, no taxes, and so many of you have been after this that now you got it. I promise you, if you do not do it, out of 7 billion of you, at least 4 billion will be dead before we even bring the species industry out of your own greed against each other. You will kill each other because in time you will not have anything to support each other. So I brought you a gift, eat from the cup, you enjoy it, drink from the cup, you die. It's very simple, depends, you choose it as a gas or you choose it as a gas. So sorry to tell you, I walked into a very big trap for over a year and a half, over 10 years, and now you're in it. Because enough people have listened, enough people have produced it, there are enough greedy people to make the system, and this is the end of humanity. You choose very, very carefully how you do it, the way you do it, and this time round, don't get it wrong. Start understanding what you've been given and start building around it that the noose has not much to create a fall. And if you fall, the heavier, the worse it will be. And if you've done enough heavy job, you fall much harder. Always remember, I was explaining this to somebody in the past few months, when they hung one of the Saddam Hussein's family, they were expecting that there'll be hanging bodies. But unfortunately, he snapped his neck, they had two pieces, and they had to reconsider all the execution in Iraq. Because they saw a man in two pieces and his body was not ready for it. So don't get to the point that you have to change it because you can't understand it. Start the new cycle that there is no need for a noose. I'm very straightforward. I warned you and now it's on the table. All of you have been busy making the little wires and ganses, but very soon, the way we put it out, everybody will know how to do it. And if the top 1, 2, 3 million people put the thing in, the problem with you is, if 1 million people in Italy make the system, the whole Italy of 70 million will have a free energy, you've seen it. So, you still, by putting a system for yourself, you dismantle the society. Because the other 7 million don't need to pay. So, now you understand. And we have played it so openly that, like a man in a greed, you just walked into the trap. Yesterday you were happy that you received free energy, free car supply. Today, you know, is a payday. Payday of your own soul, your own judgment, and your own behavior. And Keshe Foundation will supply it with the greatest of the pleasure. I've already structured the system to be, because it's the right of every man to have a life without expectation of payment by the soul. So please make as many as you like. The more you make, the closer the noose gets, unless you structure it correctly. Build one for your neighbor, don't give it free to your neighbor. Say, these are the conditions. We open a special account for your own nations, monitored by you, how you pay taxes your own nation. 20% is acceptable. We monitor, we don't need a president with 2,000 entourage. Correct? This is one of the biggest cry in this country. There are millions unemployed and the president has a 2,000 entourage. And entourage of the president at the moment, if you look, Italian man is happy what? With the manager of a shop, a restaurant, a cafe, he's happy to take home 900 euros a month, correct? Present your entourage. And now roughly, at least let's say 1,000 of them are on this payroll. In different form or shape, perks, backhander, whatever. How many of these can you put in there? You can job, you can feed 10,000 people with 1,000 entourage. Do we need leadership like this? Do we need mayors and councillors to have a huge wages to create more jobs for themselves? So, Alex didn't come here to free you. Alex came here to shackle you with your own conscience. So, what our Italian colleague says is that the president of Italy personally takes more money than the president of the United States. Much more. So you Americans have sold your presidents very cheap. You should become the president of Italy. So now you see the picture has changed since yesterday. A father gives a match to the child to learn how to make a fire, to make a barbecue, and a fire to warm himself. If he doesn't guide the child, child walks in the house, he burns the house down. So now I give him the match. Make a barbecue and enjoy a good fire. Or burn the house down, it's all in your hand. So please understand and make as many systems as you like. But go to your community, say, I made a system, I think that's what you're right. Because if you don't do, then they start putting a hunter on you, hunting who's got the system to stop the block, because this mayor still like to have his 10,000 euro per month business. Cushy life is finished. And I advise you something, please do not give nothing to the church, to the mosque, to synagogue, because they've taken enough. And don't give it to the priest to keep it for you, because it's already stolen enough from you, physically and from the soul. Organize yourself in a way that you're correct with the people and in your community. The change is so huge, you don't even understand what I'm telling you. But you will feel it very soon. Because the greed of the man will bring man to the ground. So, now, today, yesterday, we showed the electricity and emotion, and all of you are at it, building it, making it. A lot of people, as we heard, Vince yesterday says, while I start building, I'm doing it while I'm speaking. And how many people have listened, and how many people are going to repeat it? In a very short time, millions and millions and millions. And what is our friend is doing is going to Nigeria to teach people in Nigeria how to have a free energy. Do you know how many people in Nigeria, one of the richest old nations in this world, die by the fire trying to get oil that they can have a fuel at home every year? I worked in Nigerian community. Never lived there, but it's very strange. People go and cut into the pipelines to get oil. The biggest, richest nation on this world, the management, the leadership has stolen so much that at the bottom there is no wealth. People crumb, die. When these explode, hundreds die. He's from Nigeria, he can tell you. Huh? That's true. So now he teaches them a little system how to make. This man, when I got to know him a couple of years ago, he came to me in a very cheeky way. His way was, Mr. Keshe, I'm from Barbet. Where you went to college? I thought, oh, I have to see what he says. It's not that this year we got to know him just because he received the threat. Caroline has been watching his progress for a long time. We got a few people like this. They are monitoring. And he knows. And one of the things he's done, he can tell you himself. He's bought computers to go to Nigeria last year, a few months ago, to teach Nigerians how to do the GANs, how to do the system, and the computers to use it, that it creates its own energy, because there is no energy, because they steal the money. Nigerian oil leaves Nigeria officially at 120, but it's all owned by BP, or Shell Oil, in the back name. Locals get zero. If you want to know worse, Saudi Arabia charges $120, $130 per barrel. Goes to British Kingdom, British monarchy. They own Saudi Arabia. So these things are going to finish, because that guy doesn't need to do this, and nobody needs Saudi oil anymore. The situation is very simple. 1972, $2.5 a barrel was price of the oil. When the Shah of Iran made it 3.5 to 4, everywhere shouted this criminal act. Hospitals are stopped, people couldn't afford fuel. They brought us to such a point, we are even happy with 130. It's the same oil from the same dinosaurs in the same place, the same cost. In a way, they've done it to you, now you are free of the shackles of it. Free energy you have. And watch, while I've been talking, how much you've been putting in the grid. At the moment is 1.8 and it's still at 4. So you put 0.2 kilowatt more and everything is totally free. All the reactors are running your back of itself. So energy totally free. If you can, you don't need to. I can take this unit and go anywhere in the world. Is independent of the power supply now. You take this frame and walk anywhere you like. You're free. You have no problem in doing whatever you like to do. The only thing you're doing, we have a connection here to the main, which is there, and it's actually putting energy out. You're a supplier, and you're meeting all your demands, the light, the fan, and running the motors. So if you look at this frame structure, we miniaturize it, you have a free energy, and you feed yourself. So, my friends, you have walked in a very big trap. You were so greedy that your greed has brought you to your own death. It's you to choose how you're going to die, or how you're going to survive and save your nation. Do we need one nation to dictate, or now the Africans will be free of energy, Europeans will be the same, you can have a boiling hot swimming pool in the middle of winter, because the more you heat up the pool, the more energy you put outside. You have not felt it, but I know it because I experienced it for the first time when I was 17 years old. No, 15 years old. During the Shah's regime, the inequality was so huge. Where we lived, we were elite. Somehow, me and my cousins got trapped in a position unknown with the police involved, which we tried to get out of the situation. And you know what the policeman said to me? You are the rich boys, you already had our share, it's our turn. You give it to us or we take it from you. And I went home and I said to my dad, what's going on? He said, Mehran, this is the lifestyle you live. This is what they're going to do to you. The nations you robbed, they come and take it. Bring the equality the correct way, otherwise they're going to eat you up. You were stolen enough in the West. And if we show the free energy flight system is inevitable within a matter of, I have to bring somebody else in a few days and put him where Alex sits with the free energy, then you'll find millions of Chinese, millions of Indians who get born on the street and die on the street would like the luxury of your bedroom, madam. Are you prepared to give it? We've seen it in Iran. The revolution of Iran was the best example. People came to the house, they said, this is our house, you've got 2 hours to live, otherwise you're against the regime, shut the child, the mother and the father in bed, threw the bed out, they are the owners of the present. Half of the Iranian regime hierarchy this is how they lived and how they got their wealth from. People shot in bed because they lived in the luxury home. You think they're going to scare you, they're going to put you out, this is what they're going to do with you. I lived it, my family lived it, now it's your turn with the free energy. Correct it very quick, otherwise you don't know what you've done to yourself. So, walk the path, you got the free energy. I had to go to the life of revolution to understand what I'll tell you what's going to happen to you is the first experience. So, sort this out very quickly, because now even the Nigerians know how to march and how to make free energy. Do you know why? How many Nigerian friends do you have in north of London? A lot of them. Have they been watching you yesterday presenting? So all the African and Nigerian know how to be free of energy. Correct? So your noose is there. It's how you're going to hang yourself. You understand exactly what you've done. So, and don't forget, I wrote to the African nations yesterday what is going to be shown the day before yesterday, that the shackles of freedom of Africa will come from one of their own sons. And they were proud to show it in the past 24 hours. Oh boy, you got a lot coming. Because very soon, an African will fly before anybody in the West. They won't come in the boats. You have to give them a hand to save them off the sea the way it's happening now. They come with old cars with no windows which can fly in the center of New York and London and the rest. Mayhem has started. And don't forget, the most prolific scientist, one of the most beautiful scientists I know, they all come from Africa. I haven't seen an intelligent European scientist, because here you're given the money to study like a horse. African man, when he goes to get a degree in America, he cleans the floor, he washes the toilet. I can show you a lot of them. They're friends of mine. They're professors now. But to get the doctorate and professorship, they would not be given anything except when if the knowledge was good, they robbed it of them. So they had to think while they were cleaning the toilet in diversity of the knowledge how they can save themselves. And now they're back. So your biggest nightmare, it comes because you can't control them anymore. I am in a way glad to tell you what is to come. You have a time. Now, do you want to know about the health? Winds? Rick, are you there?